changes tonight regarding Iowa food safety inspections. It's a follow-up to our Best Arants and Worst Arants investigation. Patrick Bell has the new information.
Yeah, the old system, Stacy, is over effective April 1st. And don't worry, it's not an April Fool's joke. This is very serious. And those responsible for making sure your family's favorite eatery is safe promise more oversight and more efficient use of taxpayer dollars.
From flaming grills to frigid freezers, if it's inside your favorite restaurant, you can bet state food safety inspectors have checked it out. But tonight,
for the public, I think it'll be a huge improvement.
It's out with the old and in with the new.
Currently, we inspect establishments on average of about once a year. That just doesn't make sense. It would make sense that we focus our resources on those places that have a higher risk, maybe regulatory compliance issues, or are serving as highly susceptible populations.
Stephen Mondernock is the Iowa Department of Inspections and Appeals Bureau Chief for Food and Consumer Safety. His plan will increase oversight at high-volume restaurants.
The higher-risk establishments will be in at least two times a year.
Medium-risk, like fast food, will be inspected once a year.
Those places that are low-risk, which would be like convenience stores or bars that might serve a frozen pizza and chips, will be every 2 years.
It's a welcome initiative for restaurant executives like Mike Holmes of Splash Downtown.
They could come in every day, really. And to me, I'm fine with that. You got to make sure that the places that people go, they get served something that's not going to make them sick and not going to, you know, affect them in a negative way. Like I said, at Splash, we're not worried about that. Not at all. We take good care in our kitchen. If they want to review me twice a year, twice a month, twice a week, that we're fine with that. We have nothing to hide.
New plan will not, state leaders say, add any new cost to the roughly $1.7 million inspection budget, but it does only cover for now the 38 counties under state jurisdiction.
And Patrick, what about maybe smaller restaurants with a history of health problems?
Yeah, good question. They will also be considered high risk and subject to increased inspection as well, Stacy.
Okay, Patrick, thank you.
Welcome.
Now, the Department of Inspections and Appeals also warning that a restaurant inspection scam is making its way across the state. We first told you about it in November. Two Ames restaurants took calls from somebody impersonating a state inspector who was trying to get personal information from employees. And now that scam is targeting Asian restaurants across the state. Officials say there is an easy way to tell the difference between a real inspector and a scammer.
We don't call ahead of time. We won't call somebody and say, we're conducting a complaint investigation. We need the following information. We will just show up. We don't threaten people.
Investigators say those scam artists are using that personal information to open online sites in order to sell fraudulent items for profit.